we're doing here is we've got essentially a street bike without lights. We're making it legal to enter into a race. There are certain safety precautions you have to make, certain things you have to do to make it legal to race. One of those is lock wiring the retaining bolts for the calipers.
So we have special wire for that and special pliers. We put the wire through the first hole and then measure it. These pliers actually lock on, so then you just pull and the pliers wind it up. Okay, we then put the wire through the second hole on the brake caliper bolt and do the same there. So there we have that. That's safe and neat and legal. That lock wiring has to be done to the crankcase drain plug, the filler plug, the radiator cap, which I'll come back to later, and the oil filter. Now, this bike has a spin-on oil filter. Now, obviously, you can't drill that. So what you do, you spin it on, you put a large hose clamp on it, tightened up, and you lock wire that to the frame or whatever. Now, getting back to the radiator cap, it's lock wire, but when you go for scrutineering, it has to be open so the scrutineer can have a look in the radiator and make sure it's just water, not glycol, which is an antifreeze corrosion suppressant. They will also check the overflow tank too to make sure that's just water, because it's not as slippy as glycol. We also have to have a belly pan. It needs to have sufficient capacity, so if you have a catastrophic engine failure, the oil will go into the belly pan rather than on the track. It also has to have drain plugs. On a wet day, wet race, you take these out so the belly pan doesn't get full of water. Now, we also have crankcase protection. If you drop the bike, it can slide along the tarmac and rupture the crankcases, letting oil over the road. So, this, go down there, like that, bolted on, of course, and there's the same the other side. So that's about enough for me. I think I'll go and have a poppy nap.
Hey,
No chance. Okay. When they wake up.
Well, we're recording anyway, so we
okay,
can
shut up, guys.
Throw it away.
Shut up.
Yeah, you're going to come on now.
Shut up. Please, who is that?
Okay, well, here we are. We're on our way to Melbourne. We're about an hour out of Melbourne. When we get that far, we'll turn right then up towards Western Australia.
Speaking.
We've got about 8 hours drive today. Nice and easy.
I didn't know we were going to Western Australia.
No.
Dead right, South Australia. Okay, take two. It is 2 hours on take 28.
This is the moment where I do that embarrassing look at the gap on the side of the road.
Okay, we're on the road again. We're about an hour out.
On the road again.
We're about an hour out of Melbourne. When we get there, we'll turn right towards South Australia. We've got about 8 hours in the car together, so plenty of time for intelligent, incisive conversations.
Arguments.
And some amusing anecdotes, you think?
Astros.
And antidotes, so amusing antidotes.
Thank you. Thank you.
stand there, you'll check you out, mate.
Wait for the clickers to go on the
Right. And for the
pigs,
just to remind us all riders.
Big Smile. Come on, Big Smile.
Can you please bring your trunk bumpers back? Thank you.
This one, he's going to go back, you know those 3D printers?
I was out of tune. People going to drive by.
Three, two, one. Have you turned it on?